our topics are today, that is number one, it is called group, and from group we are proceeding to the abelian group. And after that, a very small introduction of ring and field. Okay, so before we start with the group, there would be a tree structure. Now, according to the tree structure, the very first one we have to know the term that is called the binary operation. The first one is called the binary operation. Now, what is a binary operation? Suppose we have a set that is A. So that is a set and it is non-empty. It is non-empty. Now, we know, suppose we have any mapping or cross product, A cross A, such that we have got the ordered pair. So ordered pair means here that one is A comma B, where A, B both belongs to A. Already we know when there is a mapping, mapping can also be considered as a cross operation or the ordered pair. Now, the mapping, so we may say the mapping, that is F, suppose A cross A, and that is also denoting to A. It is crossing to A and is called a binary operation. Yet now, very confusing. What is binary operation? Normally, it is denoted by like a small circle or sometime some asterisk sign, or it may be any other type of operation. Normally, we use that type of circle. Now, suppose what is a binary operation with example? Suppose we have a set and we have two elements, A, B. The two elements are there belonging to A. So the according to denoted by a small circle, so we can write the binary operation in that way. So that is the binary operation between A and B. A and B. I am saying that A and, but that and does not mean it is multiplication. It means normal and. So binary operation between A and B. So that is called the binary. Now, what is binary operation? It may be any algebraic operation. Any algebraic operation means it may be plus, it may be minus, it may be multiplication, it may be division, or according to our need. According to our needs. Suppose we have a binary operation example, A, binary operation B, it may be A plus B, that is a true. So here the plus, that operation, according to our normal algebraic operation addition, is a binary operation. Suppose A or B, that is also A minus B, that is true. So here the subtraction operation, algebraic subtraction operation, is treated as a binary operation. Suppose A or B, so that one is a binary operation. B, that is also a binary operation. Now, according to our needs, suppose we are writing here like that. A, binary operation B, is A into 7 by B. So here the operation is looking like very odd, but suppose that one is treated as a binary operation. So in that case, if A is equal to 5, B is equal to 7, where A and B both belongs to set of integers, positive integers. So suppose like that. Okay. So after the operation, what is going on? Now A or B or binary operation B is treated as A cross 7 by B. So each and every time it must be 5 into 7 by 7 like that. Suppose once again A is 1000 as B, A or B belonging to the positive integer, B is 9001. So A or B in that case would be 1000 into 7 divided by 9001. In that case, if we have A cross B belonging to Z plus and A is equal to 5, B is equal to 7. So in that case, what happens? Now A or B is equal to A plus B. So that means 5 plus 7, like that. In that case, that would be 5 minus 7. In that case, that must be 5 into 7. But after the operation, that must belongs to the result must belongs to that mapping. Okay, I am describing it. Suppose at that moment, that one is an example of a needy binary operation. Suppose another one. It may be A or B is equal to, suppose A by 12. So here no presence of B is also here. So if we have, suppose A comma B belongs to Z plus, set of positive integer. So A is equal to 5, B is equal to 7. So what is going on A or B? So that is only 5 by 12. So if A is equal to 12, so A or B would be 12 by 12, like that. So binary operation means it may be according to our need or according to our any algebraic operation. Suppose I am giving you another example. It may be A plus B into A. So same as suppose A or B belonging to Z plus. Then it may be A is equal to 5, B is equal to 6. So A or B or that must like that 5 or 6 is equal to 5 plus 6 into 5 because that is A plus B into A like that. So whatever be the binary operation is, that is always treated as with the normal algebraic operation or with the any type of other operation we need. Is there something clear to you? Why it is called the binary operation? Because bi means two. Bi means two. So that's why binary means the operation between the two operands. Anyone? Any confusion yet now? Okay. So next one, we are proceeding to another one thing, another one term. That one is called the closure or closed. Now, when we are writing the mapping, if A cross A belonging to A, okay, with the binary operation, that is, we don't know what it is, but with the binary operation. that whatever be the result, whatever be the result, that must belong to A. A means here, that one. Let's check what is happening here. What is the meaning of closed or closure? Because when we are proceeding to the binary operation to abelian group, that one is the first property we have to be true. We have to true. Suppose we have a operation. I am writing in that way. Binary operation. That is the first one example. Binary operation, that is plus. That means our normal algebraic addition. Okay. And the set, whichever has been given, that is Z plus, that is set of positive integers. So consider any two elements, A, B, that belongs to Z plus. So what is the binary operation here? That binary operation here is the normal addition. So suppose, according to that, generalization form is like that A or B is equal to A plus B for all, that sign is called for all. A comma B belongs to Z plus. Okay, consider any two elements which belongs to set of positive integers. Suppose the very first one I am considering, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3. So A or B, that means 2 or 3, is equal to A plus B or 2 or 3. Okay, now that 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, and that 5 is also belonging to Z plus. That means 5 belongs to Z plus. After the operation, whatever be the result is, so that is the result. Whatever be the result is, if that also belongs to that set, we called it as a closed, or we set it closure property. For any binary operation, for any binary operation, closure property is must. That means whatever be the result is, that must belongs to that particular set also. Otherwise, it cannot be treated as a binary operation. Once again, I am giving another example with that one. Let A is equal to 101, B is equal to 2003. So A or B is equal to A plus B, that implies 101 plus 2003, that means 2104. That also belongs to Z plus, because A comma B belongs to Z plus. So that means it is satisfying the closure property. So we can say that one, with the binary operation plus the set z plus is satisfied. So z plus with plus binary operation satisfied. Yet now, is that clear? What is the binary operation going on?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next one, another example we may check. Suppose the second example. Here, we are treating the binary operation as suppose our minus, that means algebraic subtraction. Okay, here the set is also treated as z plus, that means set of all positive integers. A comma b belongs to z plus. So what is happening here? That is treated as subtraction. Suppose we have a is equal to 7, b is equal to 5. So after the operation, a or b, that is treated as a minus b, that is treated as 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, that belongs to z plus. Okay. So that is right. Suppose once again I am treating A is equal to 5, B is equal to 7. So the operation A or B is equal to 5 minus 7 is equal to minus 2. That is minus. The result is a minus. That does not belong to the set of positive integers. But whatever we have said, according to the closure property or the closed property or the closed thing, that the result, whatever we are getting after the operation, if it satisfied or it belongs to the same set, then we may say the binary operation is satisfied with the set. But here, if any one result fails, and here so many results may fail, if a is equal to 1, b is equal to 7, so that is a or b is equal to a minus b is equal to 1 minus 7 is equal to minus 6. That does not belong to z plus. So that means in that cases, what happens? Now, each and every time, the z plus with minus operation is not satisfied. So that is practically is not a binary operation. In that case, that is not a binary operation because the closure property does not hold. Let's check the same thing, same minus subtraction may be a binary operation with another one thing. When we are changing the set, suppose at that moment we are writing in that way, the binary operation is equal to our subtraction, that is our algebraic subtraction. Here set is treated as z. That means set of integers may be positive or negative, because we are not treating it as set of positive integers. We are treating it as a set of integers. So whatever be the values may be, suppose we have a comma b that is belonging to z. So at first, suppose we are writing, that means a or b is equal to a minus b. So we are treating that one, suppose a is equal to 1, b is equal to 7. So after the operation, a minus b, that implies, that means 1 minus 7 is equal to minus 6, that is our result. That belongs to z, because set of integers means it may be positive, it may be negative. So we may say closure property holds. Now a may be negative, b may be negative. So we are treating it as a is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 7. So whatever be the a or b, that means minus 1 minus 7, that is minus 8, that belongs to z. Closure property holds. It may be both negative. A is equal to minus 1, b is equal to minus 7. So a or b is equal to minus 1, minus of minus 7, that one is plus 6. That also belongs to z, that means close. So in that case, z with minus is holding as a binary operation. So in that case, what is happening? The subtraction, that is the subtraction operation, when we are treating it as a binary operation, that does not hold, because the set was set of positive integers. But when we are changing the set, that is set of integers, it may be positive, it may be negative, then we are treating the subtraction as a binary operation. Up to that, is that clear? Why the binary operation may exist or not?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay, clear. So next one, from that, whatever the properties we have got at that moment, the first one is called the terms binary operation. Then the second one term we have known, that is closure property. Next one, we are proceeding to another operation that is coming from the binary operation, that is called the unary operation. Unary means the operation is from the same set to same set. That means here, case of binary operation, we have written A cross A to A. In the case of binary operation, we are writing from A to A. And here, the binary operations may be written in the form of a bar. It may be in the form of a tilde. Sometimes it may be in the form of a dash, like that. Okay, let's check what is happening here. Now, A is a non-empty set. As usual. So that means from A to A. Let us check an example, it would be better. Suppose, whatever we are writing now, from set A to set A. That means what property that must hold, that is called the closure, because from binary operation, the unary operation is coming. Suppose we have a set that we are writing it D12, and D12 means if the values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. Practically, the set is set of all factors of 12. If we write 12 in that manner, it may be written as 1 into 12. So 1, 12. 12 may be written as 2 into 6. So 2, 6. 12 may be written as 3 into 4. So 3, 4. So that means what are the factors are 1, 12, 2, 6, 3, 4. And we have written it here. The set of all factors. So that means if it is a unary operation, yet now we have not defined the operation. We have only defined the set. So that must be like that D12 to D12. That means whatever the values after operation is also belonging to D12. What is the case here? After the operation, the result, whatever you are getting, that must belongs to A. So that is also the case. After the operation, that must belongs to D12. So that is our first one thing. Second one thing, so that means that is our set or mapping. Second one, what is the operation given? It is, we are saying as an unary operation because that is not D12 cross D12 to D12. That is only D12 to D12. That's why it is called as a unary operation. So that is the unary operation that is defined. Already we have said it may be according to our needs or whatever that is defined. Here that defined operation is given as, suppose bar. And bar means key. Now that is n bar is equal to 12 minus n, where n belongs to D12. So one element, n is belonging to D12, and its unary operation gives us 12 by n. So let's check, is that really a unary operation or not? So we are just writing each and everything with some examples from here. Suppose each and every time I am defining n, first one n is equal to 1. I am giving each and every example n. So 1 bar, that means n bar, is equal to treated as 12 minus n. That means 12 by 1. That one is 12. That 12 belongs to D12. So here, the closure property holds. Next one, n is equal to 2. N bar is treated as 2 bar, is treated as 12 by n, is treated as 12 by 2, is equal to 6, belonging to D12. So the closure property holds. 6 belongs. Next one, n is equal to 3. N bar is equal to 3 bar, is equal to 12 by n, is equal to 12 by 3, is equal to 4. That 4 belongs to D12. Closure property holds. N is equal to 4, n bar is equal to 4 bar. I am writing it here, but that must not be written in the case of any type of proof. I am just giving you to describe it, nothing. So 12 by 4 is equal to 3 belongs to D12. Closure property holds. Same as the next one, n is equal to 6. N bar is equal to 6 bar, 12 by 6 is equal to 12 by 6 is equal to 2. That belongs to D12, closure property holds. And finally, suppose N is equal to 12. So N bar is equal to 12 bar is equal to 12 by 12 is equal to 1. That belongs to D12 also. So that means each and every element, whatever we have taken, that n belongs to D12, and after that the result, whatever we are getting, that is n bar, that is according to here, that must also belongs to D12. So that means we may say the D12 with unary operation, that is bar, that means n bar is equal to 12 by n satisfies. But always remember that is our unary operation, because that is from A to A, that is not A cross A to A. A or B, two elements are not involving here. Only one element is involving here according to the operation. So that one operation is, that's why is called the unary one. Binary means two, A, B. Up to that clear? Anyone? Any query? Okay. Next one, two properties we already know about. The first one is called the commutative property. That is very important. Already we know. That means A binary operation B, that also treated as B binary operation A. So that means for all A comma B belongs to, suppose, set A. So that operation, that binary operation is called holding the commutative property. So that means whatever we have learned from class 2 or 3 or 1, the addition, which is a commutative property in the case of sets, practically each and everything concept coming from particular that binary operation. Whatever the binary operations we are doing with the digital, that is also a derivation from that particular binary operations. Another one that is called the associative property, already we know. Okay, and that means A binary operation B binary operation C is equal to A binary operation B binary operation C. For all A, B, C belongs to set A. So that means whatever we are saying here, commutative property, associative property, binary operation, unary operation, all are the father of all the type of operations or calculations we are doing now. All are the conceptions coming from that particular conception. Okay. Yet now, binary operation, then the unary operation, the closure property, commutative property, associative property is a need to prove something. That's we would come next. First one, we are proceeding with that one is called binary operation. Step by step, we would proceed with the tree structure. So that means F of A cross A to A. The binary operation we are treating is as a small circle. So from binary operation, we are getting the second, that is called the unary operation. That means F A to A. We are treating it as a bar, as a tilde, or as a dash. No problem. From binary and unary operations, we are getting the algebraic structure. So another one term that is called the algebraic structure. What is algebraic structure and how we can denote it? It may be denoted in a different way. Here, it may be denoted as, suppose R set of real numbers is the set, and there are not a single operation. The binary operation combines more than two operations. Okay. Suppose it may be like that. A binary operation is B, but it is treating as where A comma B belongs to set R, like that A plus B dot A, like that. Okay, so here A and B belongs to R and two operations are there. So that is an algebraic structure. It may be written or it may be like that. Suppose once again I have R is the set and we have plus dot subtraction. So it may be like that A comma B belongs to R, where A binary operation B is treated as A plus B dot A minus B. Suppose like that. So here the three operations are consisting with the algebraic structure. It may be like that. Suppose G is the set, only one operation is there, algebraic operation. So it is looking like that A comma B belongs to G. So the binary operation A or B is treated as A plus B, suppose. Okay, so here that is also an algebraic structure. Another way of writing any algebraic structure is without the parenthesis, we can use the redirection sign. That means the greater than or less than sign. Both are true. You may also find it in different type of texts. So it may be also written like that. Dot. Okay, so it may be written like that. So algebraic structure can contain any type of operations, any number of operations. It may be one, it may be two, it more than two be, it is, it can be more than two. Denotion is like with parenthesis or with the redirection signs. So first one binary operation, second one unary operation, and after that we are providing the things that is called the algebraic structure. Now we should proceed with the algebraic structure. After the algebraic structure, the next term is called, from algebraic structure, we are getting, that is called groupoid. What is groupoid? That is only one binary operation is there. Only one binary operation. That means that R with one binary operation, that is a groupoid. Suppose with G subtraction is a groupoid, or set A with star is a groupoid, or A comma plus star, that must not be a groupoid. Groupoid means only one binary operations is there. So from that, The first one is the binary operation, second one unary operation, third one algebraic structure, then the groupoid comes. Okay, next one, from groupoid. From groupoid, we have semigroup. What is the semigroup? The first one must be, it must be a groupoid. When it is a groupoid, then we may proceed to think, is that a semigroup or not? So that means it must be with the property that is associative. Yet now I am not describing anything, but that would be described later with an example. So, five, binary operation, unary operation, then we are getting the algebraic structure. If the algebraic structure is only with one binary operation, that is called a groupoid. Now, a groupoid is holding the property of associativity, then we can call it as a semigroup. Okay, next one. From the semigroup, another one is called monoid. So what is a monoid? First one, it is a semigroup. And it has one identity element. So as a semigroup, I am describing once again, it is a groupoid. It is holding associative and it has identity element. That is the same. So six, we are getting monoid. Binary operation, unary operation, algebraic structure, groupoid to semigroup with the associativity property, then semigroup to monoid. Monoid means with semigroup, it holds the identity element or exists the identity element. So next one, from monoid. From monoid, we are getting the group. So what is a group? A group means it is closed. Why closed? Number two, associative. Number three, the identity element exists. Number four, inverse element exists. Now, why closed? Look at the thing once again. I am saying, when I have any binary operation, that must be closed. Without closed, we cannot say it is a binary operation. Now, from binary operation, we are proceeding with the second one, that is called the groupoid. From groupoid, we are proceeding with the associativity. Then we are proceeding to the identity element exist. Then from that, we are saying the inverse element exists. Practically, that closed means already we are proceeding with the very first one, that is called the binary operation, and one single binary operation is there. So practically after that, we are getting the group. So when we have to prove, is that a group? First of all, we have to prove, is that closed or closure property holds or not? Then the associativity property holds or not? Then the identity element exists or not? Then the inverse element exists or not? Next one, from group, we can say we have abelian group. Or it may be also written as commutative group. So what is an abelian group? That is our 8. First of all, it must hold the closure property or closed. Second one, it must be holding with the associativity property. Third one, identity element exists. Number 4, inverse element exists. Then 5, the commutative property holds. Okay, so that means we may say it is a group with the property of commutative. Then we may say it is an abelian group or the commutative group. Okay, so from the very first of all, we are saying the binary operation, then unary operation, then algebraic structure. Algebraic structure means it also holding the closure or closed property, then the groupoid, then semigroup, then monoid, then group, then abelian group. So whatever the problem is that an abelian group or group, we have to prove according to that order. Next of all, I am just touching the two terms. After that, we should proceed with the problem. That would be clear. After that, the ring is coming. Done. That means, yet now, whatever we have said, that is about to group. Now, the ring. Ring means that is an algebraic structure with two binary operations. Okay, so that means it may be R with R comma dot, like that. Okay, next one, that R comma plus, that means the first one binary operation with is an abelian group. So that means with one binary operation, we have to check, is that an abelian group or not? Third one, with the second one operation, it must be is a semigroup. We don't know which operation, but it may be one is an abelian group, second one must be with a semigroup. And fourth, which one is holding the semigroup is distributive. Now, already we know what is the meaning of distributive in the case of set theory. So distributive means here, suppose A dot B plus C, suppose. So that is like that, A dot B plus A dot C. So that means that operation is distributive. If those four properties hold for any algebraic structure with two binary operations, the abelian group, semigroup, and distributive or distribution, then we may say that one is a ring. From ring, we can say another one term we are getting, that is called the field. What is field? Field means it is an algebraic operation or algebraic structure. And that is also with two binary operations. That means R dot, suppose. Then, in the case of ring, first one or any one of the binary operation is an abelian group, another one is a semigroup. In the case of field, both the operations with the set is forming abelian group. And also the anyone which is holding must hold is distributive. So we are not proceeding with the ring or field at that moment, but we are proceeding with the group, because if we can prove the group or the abelian group, then we can proceed with the proof of a ring. That means the algebraic structure is a ring or not, algebraic structure is a field or not. So we should proceed with the group with an example. Once again, I am saying the properties we have said that must be sequential. That means first one is closed, second one we are proving the identity element, that is not true. The first one must be closed, then must be the association or the associativity would be proved, then the identity element exists or not, then the inverse element exists or not. Like not let that we are proving the inverse element at first, then the identity, that is wrong. Because we already know, because from semigroup, the associativity holds. So without proving the semigroup, we cannot proceed to monoid. Without proving the monoid, we cannot proceed to group. That's why those properties which are written here must be sequential to prove that. Yet now, anyone, any query? Okay, so next, I am just giving an example. Suppose the question is like that. Prove that the set of even integers forms an additive abelian group. Okay, so that is our question. So we are proceeding whatever we have done according to that. First of all, what is our set? I am writing the solution here, and you also have to be proof in that way. So what is our set? Set is here, set of even integers. Set of even integers, that means it may be plus, it may be minus, no problem, but that must be even. So we are denoting it as, suppose, ZE with the even. Okay, so it may be like that, 0, plus minus 2, plus minus 4, plus minus 6, plus minus 8, in that way. That is our ZE. Next one, so that one has been found. Which is our operation? We have to prove, is that an abelian group or not? But what is the operation? Look at the term, additive. So that additive term is giving the operation as plus, that is algebraic addition. Our normal algebraic addition. So that is our binary operation, which we are writing as like that. So the binary operation, most of the cases we have said that is used with the circle. So we are writing it like that. Circle in between the plus. Already we have written here like that. Okay, so whatever we have to prove, is that an abelian group or not? So for any abelian group, the first one we have to prove is that the closure property holds or not. So we are writing here like that, first one, suppose. So what is our algebraic structure? Our algebraic structure is like ZE with plus. So we have get the binary operation, then we have get the algebraic structure here. Okay, so the first one we have to prove, that is closure or not. Let's check. Whatever the elements we are getting, let A comma B belongs to JD. So according to that, A binary operation B, that must belongs to ZE. Then we may say the closure property holds. Okay. So for closure property, A binary operation B must belongs to ZE. Let's check with some example. That would be better. Suppose A is equal to plus 2, B is equal to minus 2. So A binary operation B, that means 2 plus minus 2 is equal to 0, belonging to JD. Suppose A is equal to plus 8, B is equal to minus 2. So A binary operation B is equal to 8 plus minus 2 is equal to 6, that belongs to JD. Suppose A is equal to minus 10, B is equal to plus 1000. All are even, we have to remember. So after the binary operation A or B, that is minus 10 plus 1000, that one is equal to 990, that also belongs to JD. So that means whatever the results we are getting after the binary operations, we have the JDE is also holding that particular result. So that means we may say closure property holds as A binary operation B is belonging to JD. So the first one is proved, that means closure. So what should be our second one? If any one property fails, then we must stop there. But we have to check that one algebraic structure is abelian group or not. Okay, so that is our question here. So next one, we are proceeding with the associativity. So let we have A, B, C belonging to JD. And for associativity, what we have to check? A binary operation, B binary operation C. So at first that one, then that must also be equal to that one. You may check any one, any three numbers. A is equal to plus 2, B is equal to minus 4, C is equal to plus 10. That always gives us A plus B plus C. If we check the result, that means plus 2 plus B means minus 4 plus 10. That is always equal to A operation B operation C. That means plus 2 minus 4 plus 10. We are getting, that is plus 6 plus 8. That one is also 8. Okay. So we may say associativity property holds as that one holds. So the first one is proved, closure. Second one is proved, associativity. Third one, check. Closed associativity, then the identity element. Now, what is an identity element? So third one, we have to check the identity element exists or not. Identity element exists or not. Always we have to remember the identity element must belong to the set. That means within the set, the identity element exists. And second one, identity element is based on operation. Identity means one, but that does not mean the identity means always the one should be there. What is an identity element? Identity element means let small I is the identity element. And that is like I with the operation with any element which belongs to that set. Here that one must be JD. JD always gives us the A. That is called the left-hand identity. That one is called the right-hand identity. So that means identity means with the operation, whatever the elements we are getting, we are doing it and we are getting the same result or same value. Here, zero is the identity element. Let's check why. Suppose zero plus any element, suppose that is plus 2, because plus 2 belongs to JD. We are getting plus 2. Suppose zero plus minus, that means the operation is like that, plus minus 10, we are getting minus 10. So that means that zero exists because zero is also belonging to JD. So zero is the identity element exist in JD, or zero belongs to ZD. So the identity element exists. Okay. Next one. Another element that must be our inverse. Inverse element. What is inverse element? Suppose we have A any element belongs to JD. Then if we proceed with like that, let inverse is here, we are writing IE, suppose IE with the inverse element. So it is looking like that A with the identity or inverse element, we are getting the identity element. I am writing here A is the element that is the operation or the binary operation, that is the inverse element, and that one is the identity element. So each and every time, whatever the element we are getting, it inverse must exist in the set. Look at the values. Suppose we have 2, then plus 2 exists, minus 2 also exists here, because that is set of even integers, and we are getting 0 here. That one is A, that one is the binary operation, that one is the inverse. Each and every time, whatever be the element is, it inverse exists, because we are getting the identity. Suppose minus 6, then we have plus 6. So minus 6, its inverse is plus 6, the operation is plus, we are getting the identity element 0. So we may say inverse element exists. So from first one, it is a closure, property holds, associativity holds, identity element exists, inverse element exists. So we may say it as a group. So we may write ZE comma plus is a group, but we have to prove is a abelian group or not. So the fifth one, commutative holds or not. And obviously for A, B, any two elements belongs to JD, we have A operation B is equal to B operation A for all A comma B belongs to JD, i.e. that is commutative property holds. Just let's check like that. If we have A is equal to plus 2, B is equal to minus 4, then A plus B, that means 2 plus minus 4, that is also true as minus 4 plus 2 or B operation A. So that means commutative property holds. So we may finally can say that operation ZE with, sorry, the ZE, the set with the operation plus is an abelian group.